What if it was possible for you to fall asleep, but to have total control over your dreams? That's one of many questions posed in the new Netflix series, Behind Her Eyes, a six-part thriller from the producers of The Crown, starring Simona Brown, Tom Bateman, and Eve Hewson.
And while we're not going to reveal plot specifics here, it's not a spoiler to know that lucid dreaming is central to the story. But what is lucid dreaming? And is it actually real? Lucid dreaming is the term used when a person becomes aware of the fact they are in a dream. The idea is that this awareness gives the dreamer the ability to influence what's happening, to generate the world around them and choose how they interact with it. This is distinct from a normal dream, in which the sleeper tends to have little or no control over what happens, and events seem to occur as the mind subconsciously drifts into them. In theory, a lucid dream is yours to control, like a vivid, boundless form of virtual reality that takes place entirely inside your head.
I'm dreaming.
And if that sounds too good to be true, it's absolutely not. Lucid dreaming is real. And it's not new either. Although the term lucid dream is a relatively recent one, coined by the Dutch author and psychiatrist Frederik van Eeden in his 1913 article A Study of Dreams, the concept is far older, with roots in the Hindu practice of yoga nidra and Tibetan Buddhism. English polymath Sir Thomas Brown described his ability to lucid dream in his 1643 work Religio Medici. And in 1867, French sinologist Marie-Jean Léon anonymously published a paper on his own experiences of conscious dreaming. So, what does Behind Her Eyes get right about lucid dreaming? Well, it's not quite as simple as stepping through an imaginary door. But with practice, it is possible, in theory, to control your dreams. It's all about training your brain to recognize when you're asleep. Something you can do, somewhat surprisingly, while you're awake. The first step people use is to keep a dream diary, similar to the one we see in the show. If you write down everything you remember about your dream when you wake up, it will help you identify signs that you're dreaming. And once you start to see patterns, you can use them as triggers to prove to yourself you're asleep.
When you do, you'll know you're dreaming. Then you picture the door and open it. You can dream anything you like.
So if you often see your childhood home in a dream, for example, you can practice thinking about how that's proof you're dreaming. Another way of forcing lucid dreams is the wake-up, back-to-bed method, which is exactly what it sounds like. You set an early alarm, spend an hour doing something wakeful, ideally reading about lucid dreaming, then go back to sleep with the intention to dream. And in fact, anything that disrupts your routine, such as moving your pillow to the other end of the bed, can encourage lucid dreaming. And finally, we have reality checks, something else we see in Behind Her Eyes. The reason Adele counts her fingers and pinches herself is to distinguish reality from the dream world. In a dream, your hand will never look the same twice. And you can use this distinction to jolt yourself into lucidity.
It happened.
If you look down and see more fingers than you have, you're obviously dreaming. Another thing is reading. You may have noticed it's almost impossible to read in your dreams. So the next time you try and fail, you can use that as a way of reminding yourself what's actually happening.
I know.
But given the subject matter, how can we be certain lucid dreaming actually exists? It's only recently that sleep specialists and neuropsychologists have been able to prove lucid dreaming exists. The problem has always been about empirical evidence. How can you verify people are telling the truth about their dreams? And how can they communicate with those studying their behaviour? While there are all kinds of brain activity measures that have been done, they don't specifically prove the existence of lucid dreams. So scientists have been reliant on the stories they're told when people finally wake up. Not the most reliable of sources. After all, how many of your dreams do you remember blow by blow? So how can we be so sure it's real? To understand that, we need to briefly look at how sleep works. When we sleep, we enter a state of paralysis.
Where are you?
This is caused by neurons in the brainstem that stop signals from the action-generating areas of our brains from ever reaching the spinal nerves and muscles. It's this process that stops you flailing about in bed when you dream of running, for example. This shutdown occurs at the same time REM, or rapid eye movement, sleep begins. This phase is unique to mammals and birds, and it's characterized by random rapid movement of the eyes and the propensity of the sleeper to dream vividly. And because eye movement is one of the few areas that isn't paralyzed during sleep, it provides a way of proving a subject is truly asleep while giving them the means to signal to the waking world. The REM theory was first tested in 1975 by Dr. Keith Hearn and verified in 1981 by psychophysiologist Stephen LaBerge. LaBerge instructed subjects to perform certain signals upon the onset of a lucid dream, such as eye movements or fist clenches, and these were logged using a polygraph. And because these signals were given during unequivocal REM sleep, it provided proof of consciousness in sleeping subjects. Furthermore, studies by neuropsychologists Ursula Voss and Martin Dresler have shown that brain activity while lucid dreaming is distinct from non-lucid dreaming or being awake, providing more evidence that lucid dreaming is not only real, but that something different is happening inside our heads when it happens. Have you ever had a lucid dream? Or did watching behind her eyes encourage you to give it a try? Let us know your experiences in the comments and subscribe to Netflix for more in-depth features about the shows you love.